So what are you waiting for, my dear students and parents? Welcome to Test Prep Card channel. This video is going to be about Motilal Nehru Institute of Technology, Allahabad, Uttar Pradesh. And we are going to cover following topics in this particular video. So this video is going to be very informative for your upcoming examinations and for your upcoming future. So let's get started and discuss that what I am going to cover in this particular video. So the very first thing what I will discuss over here is that the basic overview of Motilal Nehru Institute, then eligibility criteria plus NRI quota, reservation for NRI and Indian students, required entrance examination, course offered, required cutoff for Indians and NRIs, right, and application process as well as scholarship, which is the most important part of this particular video. So watch till end, my dear. Do not have to miss any part of this particular video. So stick over here and freeze yourself and watch this amazing video. So first of all, I would like to tell you something about MNNIT, means Motilal Nehru Institute of Technology, right? So first of all, formerly known as Motilal Nehru in Regional Engineering College, Allahabad, right? And it was established in the year 1961. You can well imagine by yourself that how old or how reputed college is this. One of the 17th regional college in India. This is amazing, right? And one more thing adds one more string, or you can say feather in it, that is associated with University of Allahabad, the third oldest university in India. So, and it was inaugurated on 3rd May 1961 by Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, laying the foundation stone of this particular college, my dear. Okay, so come to the point, and now we are going to discuss the eligibility criteria. So first of all, in eligibility criteria, two things lies over here. The first one is your age and the second one is your academic eligibility. So if I talk about age, then only applicants born on after 1st October 1995 are eligible, right? Yes, definitely. And they are required to have secondary board education, university certificate, or you can say class 10 or equivalent, or any certificate issued by the government authority only will be taken as authentic according or for your birth certificate. Okay, if I talk about some eligibility criteria of academics, then who the students and who will be the candidate who can join this particular institute. So applicants must have passed the qualifying exam, that is senior secondary, what we can say 10 plus 2 or equivalent from any stream of education as recognized by Association of Indian Universities, right? Okay. So if I talk about something else and go deep into it, then definitely applicants should have completed successfully mathematics, physics, and one of the subjects from chemistry, biotechnology, computer science, or biology, right? In 11th and or, just mind it over here, and or 12th as applicable in the respective boards. Applicants must have secured, right, the minimum of at least 60% aggregate marks, average of all subjects of qualifying examination taken together, or CGPA of 6.50 on a 10th point scale, right, or equivalent in the examination qualifying, in case CGPA on a different scale is awarded, or if grades are awarded over there, right? Okay. If I talk about some NRI students or USA board, then applicants should have a minimum total valid score of 1800 in SAT subject test, subject mathematics level 1 or level 2, you can say physics and chemistry. SAT subject test score has to be sent directly through College Board USA, right? Okay, so if you want more detail regarding SAT subject test, visit website www.collegeboard.com. Okay, the information is not end yet, right? We are going to tell you, or I am going to tell you something about the reservation for children of Indian workers, right? Some of the Indian workers are working in Gulf countries, right? And Gulf country students means children of Indian work in Gulf countries, means CIWG. And its fee structure first, right? So the 5% supernumerary seats with 15% of supernumerary quota of DASA, D-A-S-A, DASA, are reserved for the children of Indian workers in Gulf, right? 1/3 of seat from DASA quota is reserved for CIWG. The students getting admitted to NITs and IIEST, right, under CIWG category shall pay tuition fee of ₹1,25,000 per annum, either in INR, means Indian rupee, or equivalent to USD, right? Okay. So for NRI students, we have prepared an NRI ebook related to DASA CIWG quota. Kindly go and download this from the link below, right? You can get this particular link in the description box itself, right? Okay. Okay, let me tell you something about CIWG countries, right? So in this particular list, we have Bahrain, Iraq, Iran, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, means UAE. So you can find these particular countries over here under CIWG quota. Okay, so what are those essential documents you need to get yourself admitted in this particular institute? So for CIWG quota, there has to be proof of either parent working in a Gulf country, as the proof that either of the parent is working in Gulf country, that candidate has to produce all the following documents. So please mind these particular, or make a list of these particular documents carefully. And you will get the PDF and each and everything in the description box itself, right? Okay, so copy of the passport of the parents working in Gulf, copy of the parents' visa with a validity on any date in the year 2020 or 2021, right? Okay, so copy of the parents' work permit. Yes, work permit is also necessary with a validity on any date in the year 2020 or 2021. Okay, if I talk about something else, then certificate from the company, organization where is working, as proof that parents is working in Gulf country as per appendix 3 of UG brochure. Okay, so I would like to tell you something about that. We have the category, admission category, fee registration or registration fee, which is refundable or non-refundable. If I talk about tuition fees for the first semester only, right, and total amount paid along with the application form, or in case payment is done INR, or amount to be paid from with application form as well, right? So CIWG candidates, they have to pay the registration fee, which is non-refundable, $300. If I talk about tuition fees for CIWG, is INR 62,500, my dear. If I talk about total amount paid along with the application form, that is INR 62,500, which is equivalent to or plus $300. In case the payment is done in INR, total amount to be paid with application form is 84,790 rupees in INR, Indian rupee, right? Okay, if I talk about DASA non-SARC or DASA SARC, that definitely the details are given in front of your screen. You can see and you can have those details with you. Okay, so I would like to tell you something about the programs or the courses which offered this particular institute. So the Bachelor of Technology degree, that is called B.Tech degree course, that is 4-year course, my dear, right? On the first year curriculum is, and the how many courses can be covered in this particular course is that biotechnology, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science and engineering, electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, information technology, mechanical engineering, production and industrial engineering, my dear, right? Okay, let me tell you something about PG programs, means apart from the grant, right? So following programs are the running in various departments of the institute as well. Master of Computer Application, that is MCA, right? This program is offered by the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, which is most important and valuable program up to the mark, or you can say up to the new generation as well, right? Okay, so Master of Business Administration means MBA is also over here. Yes, so this program is offered by the School of Management Studies. Master of Science means MSc. These are the regular programs actually in mathematics and scientific computing. Okay, so this program is offered by the Department of Mathematics. If I talk about Master of Technology means M.Tech, the Master of Technology program is offered by all the engineering department. The M.Tech program is of 4 semester duration of full time and 6 semester duration of the part time. Okay, there are some PG programs as well. So admission is given in the following categories, my dear. I would like to tell you something about that is admission to the students who qualify GATE. So what are the criteria to get yourself admitted in this particular college, right? The first thing is in the PG program, right? Under PG program, admission to the students who qualify GATE. Admission to the college teachers through the quality improvement program. Admission to the candidates serving in the industry sponsored by the employers. Admission to the M.Tech part-time is offered by the different departments of the basic of written interview conducted by the department. Okay, so I would like to tell you something about the doctoral programs offered over here. Institute, stipend, full-time research scholar. So the course code is over here, that is 11. If I talk about the second one, that is self-financed full-time researcher scholar, sponsored full-time research scholar as well, faculty staff sponsored, project fellow of MNNIT, Allahabad, part-time research scholar. Yeah, so what is going in our mind right now, that what should be the particular cutoff to get yourself admitted in this particular college? So as far now, we cannot say, we can only predict the cutoff marks as far. And how we can predict it? Through getting the particular knowledge or getting the particular, information, the previous year's information as well, right? So B.Tech cutoff trend declined actually, right? We have five categories over here. The first one is chemical engineering. The second one is civil engineering. The third one is electrical engineering. And the fourth one is mechanical. And at last but not least, production and industrial engineering. You can see the parameter, or you can see the graph of the cutoffs, right? Okay, so this particular graph is for JEE Mains 2020 cutoff, right? Okay, so I would like to tell you something about JEE Mains 2020 cutoff for MNNIT Allahabad, that is B.Tech cutoff trend fluctuating, right? The biotechnology, computer science and engineering, the third one is electronics and communication engineering, and the fourth one is information technology, that is IT. Right, you can well imagine by yourself that what will be the predicted cutoff marks in upcoming years, right? Okay, so something I would like to tell you about the course name, category, and male, female, or what kind of cutoff you can get over here, right? Or appearing in this particular examination, how much if you will get and you get yourself admitted in this particular college. So there are criteria over here and the course as well, and the category divided into male, female, and home state and other state as well. Yes, this is a different, there is a difference between home state candidates and other state candidates. Yes, the cutoff is also different, right? A little bit high cutoff you can have over here for home state students, and a little bit low cutoff marks for other state students as well. So here we have the chart, and we have the list of this particular information, right? You can go through with this and mock up all those things and definitely prepare yourself best for your upcoming admission test and all, right? Okay, so I would like to tell you something about, and I would like to give you an answer, right? Or give you answers of your all your questions which is coming in your mind. Suppose that you are thinking about that, is admission from of this, is there any admission form of MNIT Allahabad available offline or online? So I would like to tell you, my dear, that there is no admission form available for MNIT Allahabad. Candidates need to appear for JEE Mains and Advanced exam to take admission in the institute, right? Okay, so the second question, if comes in your mind that how can I take admission in the UG course at MNNIT? So admission in MNNIT is done on the basis of valid JEE mains score. Final admission will be done on the basis of JOSSA counseling, my dear. Okay. So at last but not the least, my dear, what you were actually waiting for, the scholarship notice. So I would like to tell you something about that. Top five students based on the result of the end semester, means CPI of previous year academic year, will be eligible for the scholarship. The details are given below right now in this particular list you can have, right? So the year of a student is a second year students, right, will be awarded a scholarship on the basis of end semester examination. Means second year students will be eligible accordingly or according to the first year examination. Third year was the second year examination, and fourth year students will be for the third year examination. And the passing students are definitely, they are considered as their result considered according to the fourth year final years, right? Fourth year examination or final year examination, right? So this is the particular criteria for a scholarship as well. Okay, so if there is any further doubt, do comment below or connect with us on the link in the description, my dear. So do subscribe to our channel to keep yourself posted with new topics and new ideas. Thank you. Bye-bye and take care, my dear.